Welcome back to the chapter heat once again, and today we'll cover the next subtopic inside this topic, that is it. And we'll cover the subtopics today, what we have written in the right hand side of the whiteboard: modes of heat transfer. Generally, modes of heat transfer are three types: conduction, convection, and radiation. Then we'll explain what is conduction and explanation of it, convection, the definition of convection, and also its details. In details, we'll explain it. And number four, that is radiation, definition and explanation. And number five, the last subtopic of this chapter today, that is land bridge and sea bridge, we will emphasize on it. It is nothing but the example of convection. First of all, we can divide the substances into categories with respect to heat. Some substances are called good conductor of heat, and some substances are called poor conductor of heat. Good conductor of heat and poor conductor of heat. The example of good conductor of heat, that is most metals like copper, iron, aluminium, etc. And poor conductors, actually, what is good conductor of heat? What are the substances are good conductor? That is the substances which allow heat to pass through them easily are called good conductor of heat. And the substances which do not allow heat pass through them easily are called poor conductor of heat. Sometimes poor conductor of heat are called insulators of heat. So poor conductor of heat, examples of poor conductor of heat is plastic and obviously wood. Now, how the heat is transmitted through one body to another body, or in a single body, one region to another region, one end to other end, or sometimes the two bodies are far apart from each other, though heat can be transmitted. So all these categories are under these modes of heat transfer. We'll explain one by one. First of all, we'll explain conduction, then convection, then radiation. That's why we have just drawn 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Suppose I will make you understand these three modes of heat transfer by giving one example. These are indicated, actually we have indicated these rounds as a student. Suppose students are sitting, first students, second student, third, fourth, fifth, and sixth, and the teacher's desk is here, the teacher. So teacher has instructed in the classroom that the teacher will provide one book, and that book has to be transferred to the last student which is sitting in the last bench. Suppose only six students are there, for example. So how many ways are there to transfer this book from first student to the last student? One of the way will be if the student takes the book from the teacher, and then without changing its position, without leaving its seat, the student can transfer the book to the second next nearby student. Then two will convey the book to the third student, then fourth, then fifth, then sixth. So the book has been transferred already to the last number sixth student without leaving the positions of the student. So objective has been fulfilled, but without leaving the actual position. So this type of heat transfer we can call conduction. So what is conduction? Conduction is a process in which heat can be transferred from one end to other end without actual movement of the molecules. They only vibrate and then heat will be transferred. So this type of heat transfer are called conduction. Generally in the solid, heat conduction is occurred. I'll explain later in detail. Now, what will be the other way to transfer the book to the last student? Then the first student will leave his place or her place and directly go to the last student. If the student takes the book from the teacher and then go directly to the last student without violating the second, third, fourth, and fifth student, without disturbing the second, third, fourth, and fifth student, he himself or herself goes to the last students and deliver the book. Then this will be the other process. This will be the one type of transferring the book. So this type of transferring of the book will known as convection. In this process, the heat can be transferred from one part of the body to the another part of the body by actual movement of the molecule. So this is known as the convection. Generally, convection is occurred in the fluid, liquid and gas. Okay, water is heated up in a container or air is heated up in the atmosphere are under convection process. Okay, now what will be the third mode of transferring the book? What will be the process? How they can transfer the book by other type of way, other way? So that will be if the student, first student, after receiving the book from the teacher, without changing its position, without moving from 1 to 6, if he throws the book, if he directly throws the book to the 6th, then what will happen? So if it throws, then the 6th will receive the book. In this process, actual movement or vibration has not happened. The student has not gone to the last student, but without any medium, without any via, he throws the book and number 6 students receives the book. So this modes of transfer, what is happening in the universe, is called radiation. In this process, no medium is required. Conduction is slow process, convection is faster process, radiation is fastest process of heat transfer. So now we'll go to directly the conduction definition and explanation in detail. To understand conduction, we'll take one activity, we'll execute one activity of works. So we have taken one metal rod. One end is free and the next end, second end is in between, suppose two bricks. We have clamped it, the second end. So the next end will be free. In this way, we have taken one burner, Bunsen burner. We have taken one Bunsen burner and start heating the free end. But before that, we have attached some wax in equidistant position throughout the length of the rod. So this is nothing but the wax which we have attached on the surface of the rod. Then from Bunsen burner, from the flame, from heat energy is evolving, this is source of heat energy. So this end of the rod will take heat energy and the molecules inside it try to vibrate. It is the procedure when it will take the energy, what will happen inside it? Nothing is happened, only the molecules will vibrate. So suppose here some molecules are there, so these are the molecules inside the solid, you know, they are densely packed, they are attached densely. So if the first three molecules at the end of this rod try to vibrate, obviously it will vibrate when it will get the energy, then the second layer of the molecules get the vibration, become nearby molecules, they get the vibration, then they will vibrate in this way. Next, this vibration will goes to the third layer of the molecule, they start vibrating in this way. So first of all, the heat energy start propagating from this end and go to this direction, then the wax will melt and fall down. Then after some time, the heat will move in this direction and then the second wax bead will fall down. In this way, the heat will propagate through the rod and finally goes to the second end. So this is this type of heat transfer which is happening inside the rod, inside the metal, inside the solid, are called conduction. So conduction is a process of heat transfer in which the heat is transferred from one region to another region by without actual movement of the molecules. In this process, molecules only vibrates and transfer the energy to the second layer of the molecules. In this way, the heat is transferred. Okay, now go to the second mode of heat transfer. What I have told you, if the student receives the book from the teacher and he, without giving the book to the second, third and fourth and fifth student, he himself goes to the last bench and delivers the book to the last student, then it will be the convection. We have taken a round bottom flask and it is on a Bunsen burner. We have set set the arrangement in this way, is a Bunsen burner are there. Okay. So we have filled this round bottom flask with water. Then this round bottom flask is attached with the flame, which is from coming from the Bunsen burner. Then what will happen? It will take the energy. The first of all, the flask, which is made up of the glass, will take the heat, and this heat energy will be transferred to the water inside it. So first of all, these molecules of the water will receive the heat. Then what will happen? After receiving the heat, the density of this layer of the bottom layer of the molecules density will change, because when it will take the heat energy, it will expand. Volume expanded. When the volume expansion is going on, then mass will be constant, you know. So if volume increases, then density decreases. There is a formula, m is equal to dv or d is equal to m by v. So after getting the heat energy, this layer of the water, the volume will be increased. To make the mass constant, we know mass is always constant in the classical physics, then density will be decreased. If the density is decreasing, then it will be lighter. Then it will move in upward direction. Then if it moving in the upward direction, then this area, this region will be temporarily vacuum. So this vacuum regions, you know, molecules, this is a depletion of the molecule, depleted region of molecules. So this region is empty for a while, and at the time the remaining sideways molecules of the water, which is heavier density compared to the bottom layer of the molecules, they will come down. They will come down to fill this area. Then again, get the energy, volume increased, density decreased, again move in the upward direction. In this way, this process will continue till the whole the water will be heated up. So this type of process is known as the convection. And here you see the convection current is there. So water molecules is moving up, then come to this region, then bottom region, then again move in the forward direction. So this is nothing but the convection current. Okay, so this is the process. The example of the convection will explain in the latter, that is a land bridge and sea bridge, after some time. Now what is the definition of convection? Convection is a process of heat transfer in which the heat is transferred from hot region to the cold region. The heat is transferred from hotter region to the colder region by actual transfer of the molecules. Here you have seen the molecules has displaced its position and go to the other region. But previously in the conduction, any of the molecule does not changes its position, they only vibrates and transfers the energy to the second layer of the molecules. So this is the difference. Now go to the third mode of vibration, that is known as radiation. The radiation is the last process, and it is the fastest process of heat transfer, and it is happening. First of all, I will give you the example. You know, when sun rises, after some time the surface of the earth is getting heated, and from where this it is coming from the sun. And you know, actually up to 6 kilometers there is an atmosphere. After that, no atmosphere is there, so vacuum. So in this vacuum, this type of energy can transfer, and this is known as the radiation. One of the other example is that if you just very close to the oven, gas oven, you can feel the warmness, you can feel the hotness without touching the any utensils. So directly, if sun is there and suppose it is the earth's surface, then up to 6 kilometers atmosphere is there. In this process, heat can be transferred from one point to the other point, one region to the other region, with or without any medium. If medium is present, okay, but without medium it can transfer the heat. Actually in this process, by making some electromagnetic wave, the heat is transferred. So in this process, actually no medium is required, without any medium. So I have given the example, the third mode of vibration, by giving the student itself a media. The student has not gone to the last bench of the student, last student which is sitting in the last bench. He just throws the book, and the book, the last boy, last girl has received the book. So this type of heat transfer is known as radiation. So in this process, no medium is required. This last topic, that is land bridge and sea bridge. Now suppose this is sea and this is land, sea portion and land portion. So in the daytime the sun is giving the heat land as well as sea, but land will heat it up faster, and when land will be heated faster with respect to the sea region, then the surrounding atmosphere will be heated up. If the atmosphere will be heated up, what will happen? Then the density of the air will lowered. If the density is lowered, then it will be lightweight and move in the upward direction. The hot air move in the upward direction. You know, nature does not like any type of vacuum. So this vacuum will be fulfilled by other air, other region's air. So what will happen? Actually, from the sea region, that some air, some cold air, it is hot air with respect to the sea, it is a cold air. So cold air will rush to fill this region. And so there is a current, the wind current will flow. This type of bridge, the bridge will flow. And this type of bridge, which is coming from the sea, is known as the sea bridge. And what will be the land bridge? That in daytime, the land heated up faster. So which heated up faster? It cools down faster. So what will happen at the end of the day? So the water surface will cool down later. So when already the land is cooled down, but water surface, it is now actually not that state, not that cool down state. It will cool down later. So it is warmer. So at the end of the day, the water surface will be hot. So what will happen in that time? In that time, at this region of the sea, the surrounding air will be now hotted. Now the surrounding air will be heated up. And when it will be heated up, what will happen? Then volume increased. If the volume is increased, then density will be decreased. It will be lighter and move in the upward direction. What will happen? So temporarily, this region will be vacuum. So I have told you, nature does not like any type of vacuum. Then the air from any other region, which is the colder region, will come from and rush to this area to fill this region. And as the air or bridges are coming from land rashly to fill this vacuum is known as the land bridge. So this is the origin of land bridge. So sea bridge occurs at daytime, land bridge occurs at the night time, but the logic is the same, I have told you. So up to this today, student, and read this topic in your NCERT book, and if you have a question, then mail me. Thank you for watching my video. Thank you.